for Superman has not gone down well.
It looks cool, but it's not Superman.
Well, I like the old one.
Well, he looks like a 21st century Superman.
I like the classic Superman a lot better.
The writers and artists behind Superman believe the new image will catch on, but say if they're wrong, the old look could return faster than a speeding bullet.
Weather has played havoc with the weekend's sporting programme, including the third round of the FA Cup. Oni Bhattacharya takes a look at some of the matches which have survived the ice and snow.
The tie of the round is at Old Trafford tomorrow, when Manchester United will be hot favourites to keep their good run going against Spurs. Gary Francis' team will be hoping to avoid a repeat of their last cup tie, a 6-1 thrashing by Bolton in the Coca-Cola. Also tomorrow, Newcastle midfielder Rob Lee hopes to help his team through a tricky tie against his former club Charlton at the Valley. Last season's losing finalist Liverpool should complete the first step on the road back to Wembley today with victory over second division Burnley. And Sunderland escaped the frozen northeast for a trip to North London. They meet Arsenal this afternoon, but the Gunners could be without 9 first team regulars. In other games today, Chelsea entertain West Brom at Stamford Bridge, Middlesbrough will be hoping to record a rare victory at home to Chester, and fellow strugglers Nottingham Forest take on Ipswich at the City Ground.
And now for a special news flash. The borrowers are in town, and our intrepid reporter Catherine Milofsky has tracked them down.
Toilet rolls as big as a car, shoes made out of thimbles, and paper clips that are bigger than your hand are some of the props used to create the world of tiny people for a new film that is being made in London at the moment. It is based on Mary Norton's 1950s books about little people who live under the floorboards of an old house. The Borrowers is claimed to be the most expensive family film made in Britain since Chitty Chitty Bang Bang. The director, Peter Hewitt, who made Bill and Ted's Bogus Journey, claims that borrowers are not just small human beings or beans.
They have their own handshakes, their own style, a way of talking, a way of walking and hiding, their own borrower creeds.
And borrowers also have their own special dress code.
My shoes are rubber thimbles, you know, which you can count money with in the banks. The belt is a bootlace, and my dress is a shirt cuff, and on my belt I've got paper clips, bits of rope, bags, and my big bag is a baby's glove.
The film will be in your local cinema this summer, but until then, do you know who's living under your floorboards?
And we happen to know that the baby of the Spice Girls, Emma B, apparently had to leave a New Year's Eve party when her mum arrived to pick her up. Mrs. Bunton is said to have taken her daughter home to bed at 3 o'clock in the morning following a private party in London. And now the weather. Many places will be dry but cold. Just a few light snow showers in the south and some wintry showers around northern coasts. The bitterly cold wind will give quite a wind chill across the south, but it will slowly brighten up across northern England and Northern Ireland. Well, that's it from me. Have a very good weekend. Bye-bye.
Oh, hiya. We're busy, busy.
Sorry, Quill.
It's too early in the morning for all this rushing around.
The bubble bank will be at full power in 20 minutes.
After moling a hole.
There's someone living out in the garden. Someone living deep underground. Beneath the leaves that fall under the trees, somebody is digging around.
Can you see a mole in the garden? He's tunneling all over the place. With his tiny pink claws on the end of his paws,
he'll meet you with a smile on his face.
It's a mole in the hole, and he's saying hello.
So wee baby you are.
Get ready, let's go.
Cause we're looking for a mole in the garden. Somebody we know.
Who can it be?
Just wait and see.
Can you see a mole in the hole?
A mole in the hole.
Mole in the hole.
Mole in the hole.
I see. Bug alert. In 20 minutes.
So, it's crystal balls after
brilliant bubbles.
He lives in cloud nine and he's watching all the time. Who do I mean?
Professor Bubble.
You've got it. He'll show us all the things that Mother Nature brings. What's his name?
Professor Bubble.
That's me.
With Beamer, Mouse, and Quill, you'll be mystified and thrilled.
When through the bubble scope you see a fish.
Or an antelope.
And Cromarty will sing, and a story she will bring.
You'll be watched by the teeth on the bubble scope screen, Professor Bubble.
Ted, where are we going?
To the planet Earth.
Well, that's a long way to go, just to teach Spotty how to cross the road.
Yes, but it's the best place to learn. Earth has the worst traffic in the galaxy. And besides, remember what happened on the planet Spot.
Super Ted! Spotty!
Look, Super Ted, there's Blotch!
Blotch! Blotch!
No, Spotty, don't!
great moves of
Spotty! I'd better say my secret magic word! Gotcha!
Oh, thank you, Super Ted!
Now, Spotty! First, find somewhere safe to cross where you can see clearly both ways. Not behind a bus, Spotty.
Oh, sorry, Super Ted.
When you're ready to cross, don't stand too close to the edge of the road.
That's better, Spotty.
Then you must look both ways and listen. If there's anything coming, you mustn't try and cross. Then when you're sure that nothing is coming, walk carefully across the road.
Don't run, Spotty. You might fall over.
And all the time you must look and listen for traffic until you are safely on the other side. Remember, I can't be there to save you, especially on the planet Earth.
Do you often leave something soaking? The breakfast pan till lunch, the lunch dish till supper, the roasting pan till next morning. But now it's easier, thanks to new Best Ever Fairy. On grease, it's 33% more powerful. So after a short soak, new Fairy removes even stuck-on grease better. So more often when Fairy's finished, so have you. New Best Ever Fairy on grease, it's 33% better than the best of the rest.
For decades, the world has hungered for the secret. The elusive secret that makes Kellogg's Frosties one of the most awesome cereals on Earth. But just one person knows it, and he's only saying two words.
They're great!
Only Kellogg's Frosties have Tony's secret formula.
What are you going to do about it? You can do something. Talk to an adult you trust, your parents or a teacher, and don't suffer in silence.
Hi there. Oh, at about 7:10, we'll be waking up in a wild room. But first of all, something's stirring in the kitchen.
It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the